Right. In this class, we will be looking into the representation technique of sparse matrix. Earlier class, we have seen that how to represent the sparse matrix by using triplet representation. That is using row value, column value, and actual value. So this was the notation which already we have seen. Now another type of notation here is by using list or by using linked list. Representation of sparse matrix by using linked list. That is another technique which is used for representing the sparse matrix. That is sparse matrix representation. So the other type of technique for this is we use the linked list. Like this one already we have studied, and here we are going to use the linked list. So for representing that, we use two different types of nodes here. One is header node, another one is called as element node. What header node contains? It is going to contain basically three pointers. Next pointer, which will point to the next header node. Down pointer, which will point to the header node below it. Right pointer, which will point to the right node to the right side of it. That means usually we use circular representation in this. Usually we use circular representation in this notation. Right? So what we do in this representation, we represent each column of a sparse matrix as a circularly linked list with a header node. So that is the main aspect in this one. In this type of representation, what we do, each column of a sparse matrix is represented as a circularly linked list using circular linked list with a header node. Similarly, we use the same representation for each row of the sparse matrix. That is, every row is represented by using circular linked list. Every column is also represented by using circular linked list. So with these notations, now header node is, as we are going to make use of, for every row, circular representation. For every column, circular representation. So as we have these notations, we use two types of node in this, header node and the element node. Header node consists of three fields. Next field, which will point to the next header node. Down, which will point to the next header node which is present below that. Right, which will point to the next node which is present to the right side of that. So these terms are self-explanatory. So all these terms are self-explanatory. So the nodes will point to next, the pointer will point to next node, down node, and the right node. Similarly, element node. So this is going to represent the actual data. This is going to represent the actual data. That means what is the row value of the non-zero element, column value of the non-zero element, what is the actual value of that particular non-zero element, and down will point to the next node below it, right will point to the next node to the right of it. So these pointers are self-explanatory. These things will be much clearer when I take one example of a sparse matrix. So this is what is an example of our sparse matrix. This is what is an example of sparse matrix. Why it is sparse matrix? Because there are very less non-zero elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Only 6 non-zero elements are there and remaining all are zeros. What is the order of this sparse matrix? Order of this sparse matrix is it consists of 5 rows and 4 columns. Right? It consists of 5 rows and 4 columns. This is what is order of this, and we need to represent only these non-zero elements. We need to concentrate only on these non-zero elements. So let us see the representation, how it will get represented. So for that purpose, first we have to write the header nodes as it is. See, the order of this linked representation, I'll just try to reduce the size and I'll just try to show it. Right, in the single screen, I'll try to compress it and display the linked representation. This is what is the linked representation of this sparse matrix. So what the first header node indicates? The first header node indicates the order of the sparse matrix and number of non-zero elements. So it has 4 rows and 5 columns. 5 rows and 4 columns. 5 rows and 4 columns. It is represented in the reverse way. Here it is given in the reverse way, which is not correct. And how many elements are there? 6 non-zero elements are there. And even though you reverse this, this is not going to affect it. Affect because the maximum number of header nodes is equal to the maximum value among the rows and the columns. That means whichever is maximum among these rows, how many rows are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows are there. How many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 columns are there. Which is maximum? 5 is the maximum. So now consider in the representation, we will be considering the notation in such a way that 5 into 5. Sparse matrix representation, we consider the 5 into 5 nodes. Because whichever is maximum, that is going to form the rows and columns. That means number of header nodes. So now we can see here 5 cross 5. First header node, second header node, third header node, fourth header node, fifth header node. Write them as it is. Then next, in the column here, first header node, second header node, third header node, fourth header node, fifth header node, as it is. So that we should write them first as it is. So this is just blindly you write first these boxes. Later you'll study. Now for now, you just ignore these arrow marks. If you consider the arrow marks, you may get confused. So now just ignore the arrow marks. Just concentrate on these boxes. So this is what it is. It is an element node. It is an element node. It is an element node which indicates there are totally the order of the matrix is this one. And how many elements are there? 6 non-zero elements are there. And it is connecting to next header node. Because what header node consists of? Header node consists of 3 fields. Next field, down field and right field. I'll show it once again. Here, header node we have studied, right? Next field, down field and right field. What element node consists of? Row, column, value, down and right. Right? These are the things. So with this value, what we do here is we have written these header nodes. All the header nodes are written and all the header nodes row wise they are written and column wise written. Everything it is empty now. All the things are empty. Just ignore about these nodes and arrow marks. Just ignore about these nodes and arrow marks. What I'll do, if possible, within this screen, I'll try to show it. If possible, I'll try to draw it and show it because the space may not be sufficient for me. The space may not be sufficient if I draw it like this. One second. We need to think of timing also. Right? One second. Now how I can do here is I can do it in a better way. First let us write all the nodes as it is. What is this first node? Write it as it is. Header node. And 1, 2, 3. 5 rows, 4 columns, 6 non-zero elements. And this is the pointer. Write these pointers as it is. Right? That is first element node. Next, write next header, which consists of 3 fields. Next header node. First, I am writing blank. Later I will show you how to perform interlinking, because if everything is readily shown, you may not get how to link that, how to link those nodes, right? Here it is written. Now next, write next header node here. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right, all these are blank header nodes now. I'll just give labels to them. H0, H1, H2, H3 and H4. All are blank header nodes. Next, I'll give names for these. H0, header 1, header node 2, H2, H3 and H4. Now, this is just a normal header node. Now, what you have to do here is, as these are header nodes, what are these fields? It will point to the next node, this will point to the down node, and this will point to the right node. This is known fact to us. Now, how do we represent the elements? How do we represent the elements? Right? So, which is the first non-zero element in this matrix? So let us go back to the sparse matrix. Which is the first non-zero element in this sparse matrix. So where is the first non-zero element? This one. So where it is present? It is present in 0th row and 0th column. I will label those 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So where this 2 is present? 2 is present in 0th row, 0th column. So let us go to this representation. Where this is 0th column, 0th row, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0th row, 0th column, here you should represent it. What? Represent that first element. What is that first element? 2 is the first element. So these are the element node, elements, locations of the element node. Where this 2 is present? Here I'll go back to sparse matrix and show you. Where the first non-zero element 2 is present? It is present in 0th row, 0th column and value is 2. So it is present in 0th row, 0th column and value is 2. This linking I will explain you later. Just first write the elements. What is the next non-zero element? Next non-zero element is 4. Where it is present? First row and 0th column. Write it. First row and 0th column here. Write that. Represent that element. So where it is present? First row, 0th column. What is that element? 4. Right? What is the next non-zero element as per the sparse matrix? Next non-zero element is 3. Where it is present? First row and third column. Where it is present? First row and third column. While writing, if you have rolled sheets, you can write them properly. It must come exactly below that. Right? Which element we are representing? We are representing 3. Where it is present? First row and third column. Where it is present? First row and third column. What is the next non-zero element from the sparse matrix? 8 is the next non-zero element. So where it is present? Third row, 0th column. So 8, where it is present? Third row, this is third row and 0th column. Third row and 0th column. Third row and 0th column. Which element is that? That element is 8. Next one we have, next non-zero element is what? 1. Where it is present? Third row and third column. So third row and third column here, it should come below this. Third row and third column. Here it is present. Third row, third column. What is that element? 1. Similarly, we are left with last non-zero element. What is that last non-zero element? 6. Where it is present? Fourth row, second column. 6. Where it is present? Here only. Fourth row, second column. So it should come here. Right, fourth row, second column, somewhere here. If you have rolled sheet, you can write the represent that properly. Okay. Fourth row, second column, element is 6. Now all these are nodes which are successfully represented. What we have done is we have represented all the nodes, header nodes and element nodes successfully, they are represented. Now we have to perform linking based on the explanations. We have to perform circular linked list, horizontal circular linked list and vertical circular linked list, horizontal circular linked list and vertical circular linked list. Property of this is to point to the next node, make it to point to next node. Property of this is what? To point to the next node. Property of this is to point to the next node. Make this and to point to the next node. Make this and make it to point to the next node. So why I am writing like this? Because they are the properties of those nodes. See here, we have studied. Header node, next will point to the next node. Down will point to the down node, right will point to the right node. So just based on these explanation only I am writing. Right? Next, you have to form a circle by taking this head. Last node, bring it back. So as I am overwriting, don't get confused. Bring it back and make it to point here. You have to make a circular linked list. Now you can assume, can you see the circular linked list here? Now it has become a circular linked list, horizontal circular linked list. Similarly, let us connect these next elements. What is that? Where it should point? It should point to the next node. What is the property of this? First, let us complete all the horizontal. Next, what it should contain? It should come back and point to this node. If you want, you can take it down also, below that also. Right? What is the property of this node? Property of this pointer, it should point to the next node. Property of this pointer, it should point to the next node. Property of this, it should come back and point to the header node. So what I'll do, I'll take this and one second. Take it, and now we have space here, that's why I'm taking it down here. Make it to point here. Right? I am making this horizontal circular linked list now. What is the property of this? To point to the next node, but there are no next node. So what you have to do here is take this pointer and make it to point to itself. It's pointing to itself because there are no next nodes in the representation. There are no next nodes in the representation. Where it should point? It should point to the next node. Where it should point? It should point to the next node, right node. Right? Where, one second, it has been not divided. Now, where it should point? It should point to the header node back. So take it. I'll take it from the bottom. Take it and bring it back and make it to point to header node. Just horizontal link we are performing, not more than that. Next, this where it should point? It should point to the next node. What is the next node in this row? This one. Where it should point? Come back and point to this node. Right? Horizontal linking we have done. That means all the horizontal circular link lists are over. Now make the vertical circular link list. Vertical circular link list. So where this pointer, I'll take different ink for showing vertical list. So that there will not be confusion. And I'll take the red color for representing vertical. So what is the property of this? You should point to the node below it down. What is the property of this? You should point to the node below it down. What is the property of this? It should point to the node below it. What is the property of this? It should point to the node below it. But there is no next node below it. So it should come back and point to the original header node. So take this pointer, make it to point to the original header node. Right? Next. Is there any down node here which is present? No. There is no other node. So what I'll do? I'll make it to point to itself. Is there any other node which is present here? Yes, we have a node. Take this down and make it to point to 4. What is the property of this node? It should point to the next down below this, but there is no node. So what you do? Come back. Make it to point to this node. I hope you are understanding. Just horizontal circular link list and vertical circular link list we are preparing. What is the property of this down node? It should point to the node below it. So H3, it should point to the node below it. Next, what is the property of this? You should point to the node below it. What is the property of this? You should point to the node below it. But there is no node below that. What you do? Come back and point to the header node. So take it back and make it to point to the header node. What is the property of this node? Down. It should point to the node below it, but there is no down. What do you do? Come back and point to itself. Right? This is what is representation. That's it. This is what is linked representation of the sparse matrix. So both the types are most important. So what you have done in this case here is, first thing is you have to write all the header nodes as it is. And the maximum number of header nodes is decided by the maximum of number of rows and columns in the sparse matrix. If there are 5 rows and 6 columns, then you have to take 6 into 6. If there are 8 rows and 10 columns, you have to take 10 into 10, whichever is maximum. The first header node will contain order of the matrix and number of non-zero elements. So all the non-zero elements are represented. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just go on forming horizontal circular link list by following the properties of nodes, by following the properties of pointers. Then go on forming vertical circular link list by following the properties of nodes. So this is what is linked list representation. Or in other words, we call it as linked representation. Linked representation of sparse matrix. I hope this is a very small concept and it's an interesting one. Because in the earlier class, we had studied the triplet representation, not this one. Now I have tried to cover this other bit also.